good afternoon. At the very outset, before we start this small session on how do I look after my pacemaker, I wish to share with you that COVID times are here. We must take utmost care. We must continue to behave in a COVID sensitive mannerisms. We have had sessions in the past where we've spoken about the mask wearing, social distancing, and hand hygiene. We are right there where we were about a year ago. So please remember that we must remain and continue to have COVID-sensitive behavior. Coming to the subject that we wish to speak on today is how do I take care of a pacemaker? So let me say, why do we choose it? We choose this subject because there seems to be an inherent fear among people that if they were to have any kind of a device in their body, it may hamper their daily living. To which I have a very simple thing to say, that whenever we as medical personnel intervene, it is only to make the life of fellow mankind better. So when we give any devices, be it in the heart, be it in your knees, be it in your shoulder, all of these are meant to make your life better. So if you were to speak about pacemakers and we were to talk about pacemakers, the whole thing we have to understand is who needs a pacemaker is to be understood first. So who needs a pacemaker? I will just try and make you understand that this is the structure of the heart. We have two upper chambers and we have two lower chambers. For all of us, the electrical impulse comes from the upper chamber. It first goes to the upper chamber, then it goes down with the help of special electrical wires. This is just like you have electrical wires in your home. Similarly, we have electrical wires in our heart. More often than not, just as in your homes, the electrical wiring can break. You call the electrician. The electrical wires may switch off for some time. Similarly in the heart, these electrical wires can become dysfunctional as we age. Sometimes the natural pacemaker of the heart begins to work slowly, and at other times the other part of the electrical system may become dysfunctional. So how does a patient present itself? The patient presents themselves with weakness, fatigue, or may have very dramatic symptoms such as having a fall and fainting. So whenever in your family, if an elderly patient or a middle-aged and above complains of fainting spell, it needs to be given its due importance. You must seek medical attention. You must do an ECG. Right now we have several diagnostics which we can do. An ECG picks up the rhythm right then. Sometimes the ECG may not pick it up. Then we tell our patients to do a Holter. This is how the Holter looks. Look, it is so simple. It just has three electrodes which are stuck to the surface of the chest, and this is a pocket. He keeps this device in his pocket. It records ECG for 24 hours, 48 hours, maybe 1 week, maybe 2 weeks. That is the utility of an extended loop recorder or a Holter. Sometimes we may use an ECG machine as compact as this. Look what this is. This is like a visiting card. But technically, it is so advanced. What does this do? This records an ECG. How does it do that? It is very simple. All we got to do is have an application on our phone and we hold this device in our fingers, our thumbs. Just by simply holding this little device, which is just like a card, your visiting card, you can record your ECG in the comfort of your home, capture the episodes of dizziness, and immediately send to your. So I think we had a little technical glitch. So taking off, this is how a cardiac implantable device looks. It could be a pacemaker, It could be a defibrillator, it could be a biventricular pacemaker with a defibrillator, and typically these devices look like this. These are bigger, they are defibrillators, the pacemakers are much more smaller, but that's how they look, the pacemaker, and these are the leads. The leads go inside and the pacemaker is inserted. So that is to tell you a little about who needs a pacemaker. You have just understood that. And then how is the pacemaker implanted? I just told you the pacemaker is put placed under the left collarbone and the lead goes inside the heart. And that is how a pacemaker is implanted. Now I'll tell you, after we get the pacemaker, how is it that you have to look after the pacemaker? It's not just the pacemaker. They are called cardiac devices. They could be a pacemaker, it could be a defibrillator, it could be a cardiac resynchronization therapy defibrillator, it could be any of these devices. How is it that you need to look after them? So you should not be worried. These devices are only to make your life better. So to say, once this pacemaker is implanted, during the acute phase, because this is placed under, like this pocket, we make a pocket and we stitch up the skin here. You cannot see anything from outside. But because it is a raw pocket, we have just made one, you have to ensure that you take a course of antibiotics. The course of antibiotics typically lasts for about 5 to 7 days. You must try not to miss your antibiotics. Some of us may be allergic to antibiotics or may have some problems like nausea, loose motions. You need to go back to your doctor and your doctor may change the antibiotic. The reason we give antibiotics after the implant is we have to be very careful. Whenever we give implants, we don't want any infections to take place. Those patients who are diabetics must ensure that their blood sugars are well under control, because we don't want high blood sugars during the procedure, which can at times give rise to infections after the procedure. So the first thing is to remember that you have to take antibiotics, and the antibiotics must continue for at least 5 to 7 days. The next thing you have to remember is when you go home after the pacemaker, you must remember that you can lift your arms up to this level, the shoulder level. We always instruct our patients to remember to keep your shoulder mobile. A subset of patients are very scared and they have pain, so they do not raise their shoulder. By doing so, if you don't raise your shoulder, it can result in a frozen shoulder. So what we tell our patients, the first 5 to 7 days, raise your shoulder up, raise your arms up to shoulder level. Subsequently, you can take your arms above your shoulder level. And these are all instructions when the pacemaker is implanted. We also instruct our patients that they should not bathe for about 5 to 7 days after the pacemaker is implanted, because it is a raw wound. It is healing. We don't want that there should be any infection in the pocket. You must remember, sometimes the pacemakers are given in summer season. We must ensure that the patient is not in a hot and a humid climate. We don't want the patient sweating and the patient's sweat falling on his own wound. By doing so, again, if it is all soiled, it can get infected. So up till now, I have been repeatedly saying and talking about how we need to keep our pacemaker site clean, dry, and should not get infected. We keep calling our patients every 48 hours for a repeat dressing. We do these dressings at least 3 to 4 times. And we like that our patient goes back to the same doctor who has implanted, because by doing so, we are all in close contact and we are able to assess the healing of our patients. In most patients, the local site heals in 5 to 9 days. However, there could be some outliers wherein the wound can take a bit longer. It is important to understand that we should not become impatient. We should continue to seek appointments with our doctor and keep going back, so that your implanting doctor is confident and tells you that you don't need to come back again. Till then, keep going back to your doctor. normally has absorbable sutures. However, when you have any injury wound, what you should remember is when you have a pacemaker on the left, you should avoid sleeping on the left. If you have a pacemaker on the right, avoid sleeping on the right for at least 1 week to 10 days because we do not want any blood collection on the pacemaker site. Along with this, I want to tell you, those of you who are on blood thinners and need some procedures like a pacemaker, it's important to discuss with your doctor that you are on blood thinners. We may want to either stop the blood thinner for a day or two, or we may want to do the procedure on the blood thinner depending upon your clinical condition. At this very time, while we are talking about this, I think it's important we also discuss at the very end about the vaccine and blood thinners, because many of you would want to learn about what to do with blood thinners when you have to get vaccinated, which I will certainly touch about. If you want to develop fever at any point in time after the pacemaker in the first 1 week or 10 days, you must immediately go back to your doctor. Now the most important thing is a cell phone. Whenever you are using a cell phone, you should try to keep the cell phone on the contralateral ear. Means, if you have a pacemaker on the left, use your mobile phone from the right. If you have a pacemaker on the right, keep your mobile phone on the left. This you have to follow for a lifetime. The reason being, there are certain magnets which are within the pacemaker. These magnets may interfere with your pacemaker. So much so that we should all know that the newest generation of iPhone, which is called iPhone 12, those of you who are using, please listen to this carefully. Those of the patients who are having an iPhone 12 and have cardiac devices, especially like defibrillators, must remember to keep their iPhone specifically away and should not place the iPhone in their upper pocket. You should always keep your cell phone in the pockets of your trousers or in your handbag. Do not place your smartphones in the chest pockets. Even more so if you are having an iPhone 12, because you must be aware that the charging strategy of iPhone 12 has been altered. They have come out with a little pad, and you can place your phone on the pad and charge it. As a result, what they have done, that the iPhone has a very strong magnetic field inside. The iPhone 12, if you were to place it in your upper pocket, there could be some issues. So remember always to use your iPhone from the contralateral ear. The next thing which comes up is the electrical appliances at home, which applies to the time, all the time you have a pacemaker or a cardiac device implanted. So what happens when you have a microwave or you have your mixie, you want to use your mixer, you want to use a television remote, you want to use a remote phone. So you should remember that all the electrical appliances at home can be used when you have a pacemaker. A word of caution is that when you are traveling or you are working or you are staying where there are very strong electrical transformers, the ones that you see which are placed in colonies to supply the electricity, you should not be hovering around those electrical transformers because they have magnetic fields and they can interact with the pacemaker. When you are at airports, whenever you have a pacemaker or a cardiac device and you are at the airports, what you should remember is CISF personnel do, you can just walk through them. The handheld device for the surveillance, they do not bring it if you show them the card. You must always carry your cardiac device card in your wallet. Once you show them the card, they do not bring the handheld device on the pacemaker pocket. So you should remember that it's a very safe environment today. And we have, in fact, now we have pacemaker safe electrical appliances if your doctor asks for an MRI. Today, most of the devices that we have are MRI compatible. Most devices allow you to have an MRI done. So when you get the implant done, you should talk to your doctor. You should want an What does it mean? MRI compatible device, as the name implies, means that if you have a device, you can have the MRI done of your body if you need it times to come. If you have an MRI non-compatible, it is challenging and it is not yet completely advisable that you can have an MRI done. So other than that, I think I would like you to know that you should know the make, the industry make of your device. You should always carry the card of your pacemaker or the cardiac device. You should be knowing whether it is MRI compatible or not. You should be in constant touch with your doctor. Your device has to be interrogated or checked every 3 to 6 months. There are several ways it can be done. You may want to visit us and attend a pacemaker clinic, or you can also have a device checked remotely at home. Outside of this, you should remember there are battery operated devices. The battery is embedded in this unit. When we change the battery, when the battery finishes, we remove this device and we implant a new device. We do not just remove the battery. We remove this device and we give you a new device. So these are battery operated devices. The typical life of these devices varies anywhere between 7 to 14 years, depending upon what device we are using. So I think I would like to conclude here and I will be happy to take some questions.
Right. Thank you, Dr. Aparna. We have few questions for you. Like this viewer is asking what kind of exercise he can do after a pacemaker implant.
So the kind of exercise that you can do after a pacemaker is you can do all kinds of exercises. What you should not do largely is either picking up very heavy weights or circular motion of your shoulders. I just showed you that we implant the pacemaker and this is the lead. So you must remember, they are very soft leads. So this lead is here. This lead is the Achilles heel. If you injure it, then you will have to change it. So if you want to protect your pacemaker and the system well, not having any trouble, the exercise which you should not do is circular motion of your shoulder or lifting very heavy weights. Outside of this, you can do all kinds of exercises that you may desire.
Thank you, ma'am. The another question is, can I drive if I have a pacemaker?
Yes. So if you have a pacemaker implanted or any cardiac device, typically we'd say that you must wait for the local site to heal, which is about 2 to 3 weeks. Subsequent to that, you are allowed to drive. However, if you have a device like a defibrillator, which is put in people with a failing heart, in that situation, you must talk to your doctor, when can you go back for a drive, because if your ICD has given you a therapy, it is best advisable that you wait for 3 to 6 months before you go back to driving. If you have a pacemaker, you just need to wait for about 3 weeks and you can go back to driving.
Right, thank you, ma'am. Another question we have is, do I need to tell my dentist or doctor that I have a medical device implanted?
Yes, I think that's a very important question. Whenever you go for a dental procedure, at times.
Another question is, what should I do if I hear a beeping sound coming from my heart device?
So these cardiac devices are very intelligent, robust devices. They are fed in data and they are taught what to do in strenuous situations. Such as, if the simplest of all is, if you are in a far-flung area and especially in the times of COVID, you are unable to visit and you hear a beep from your pacemaker, it may be telling you on its own that the battery is depleting. It will also be telling you that the lead that I showed you is dysfunctional. In cardiac devices which are beyond the pacemaker, we feed the device much more data to give you an audible alarm which sounds as if there were an ambulance running. And it may be a good idea when you get your pacemaker implanted to discuss with your doctor and listen to the audible beep before you leave the hospital, so you should know that if I listen to a beep, it is telling me something that I need to be careful about.
Right, thank you, ma'am. Another question from our viewer is, like, can I use stairs for 4th or 5th floor daily if I have a pacemaker on an ICD?
A pacemaker under no circumstance is making you not use the flight of stairs. Remember, when you have a pacemaker, you will behave and you will do everything like all other people do. What important when you have a pacemaker is, as I told you, do not do heavy weightlifting or circular movement of your arm. Outside of that, you may climb a flight of stairs. But the question also was about the defibrillator. If you have a defibrillator implanted, as I just showed you, this is what the defibrillator looks like. It is given to patients who have poor pumping of the heart. It may not be advisable to climb 4 flights of stairs. But those of you who have pacemakers can certainly climb as many flights as you may desire.
Ma'am, another question we have is, will I feel the pacemaker working?
So, you will not feel the pacemaker working. As I told you, these little devices are extremely intelligent and robust and trained to work in a specific mannerism. They just quietly keep working. They will never let you know unless they become dysfunctional. If they become dysfunctional, you may find some twitching in your area, or you may find twitching of your abdominal wall. In routine activities, for most of the people, you will never know whether your pacemaker is working. You need to go back to your doctor and visit the pacemaker clinic every 4 to 6 months to know if your pacemaker is working appropriately and the leads in the device are working all right.
Right, thank you, ma'am. Another question we have is, can I wear a gold chain around my neck?
You can certainly wear a gold chain because it is an inert metal. There is no problem. What you should not wear around your neck is anything that is magnetic. So, like, what can it be? Like, for instance, people wear the Fitbit. Don't wear the Fitbit around your neck. Some people like to hang it in their necklace. Don't do that because these are all magnetic devices. What you must remember is there should be no magnetic device in the vicinity of 6 inches of your pacemaker. So if you are wearing, if your pacemaker is on the left, you could use a mobile on the right because it is more than 6 inches away. So you should remember the rule of 6 inches. Keep all magnetic items 6 inches away from your pacemaker.
And there are so many questions for you. We'll take the last question. Is there any precaution need to be taken around microwaves and other kitchen appliances?
So as I just mentioned, all appliances can be used when you have a pacemaker. The only appliance which you should be cautious about is if you go for a physiotherapy. And in a physiotherapy, if they use which is called something called TENS, transcutaneous electrical neurostimulation, such devices. In your homebound devices, you can use most of the electrical appliances at home without any worry. Then you can take it to one or two more.
Okay. Another question we have is, can I go through the metal detectors and security checkpoints in the airport?
Yes. So I just mentioned that when you have the metal detector and the security checkpoints, most important is always carry your cardiac device card. As soon as you show your cardiac device card to the security personnel, they are already duty bound not to bring the handheld device on your device, on your pacemaker. And they will not do it. But when it comes,
I have a pacemaker, will I be able to use laptop?
So when you have a pacemaker, you can use all electrical appliances of daily living. There should be no concern. The only thing I mentioned is that do not place your smartphone in your upper pocket. Outside of that, you can certainly use laptops when you're working.
And one more question we have, that can I use equipment like hair dryers and microwaves? I have heard that it stops pacemaker working. Like,
okay, so I don't know why you heard that, but if you are in your home and your electrical grounding in your home is done well, you can use all electrical appliances including your hair dryers and microwave. There should be no fear of using these. What you should understand is if you go for a physiotherapy, that's where you should be careful about what kind of physiotherapy unit is your physiotherapist using. It is then that you need to connect with your doctor. Outside of that, all electrical appliances inside your home can be used safely.
Thank you for your answers, ma'am. That's all the questions we have for today's session.
Thank you so much. And I think my next session I will try and cover on the COVID vaccine. I'm sure we'll have more audience. Maybe we can speak on blood thinners and COVID vaccine. We would like to seek your inputs if that you think is a good subject. Thank you very much. Stay safe.